This video was recorded with the Elgato Gaming HD60S. To learn more, click the link down below in the description. Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to give you my honest opinion on Modern Warfare multiplayer. I've had two separate occasions to play this game. The first time was back in May, and the second time was just a few days ago, back in July. Overall, I have about 9 hours in this game so far, and I feel comfortable giving my first impressions, first feelings, and opinions on it. I want to give a big thank you to Activision for flying me out, providing hotel and travel accommodation. Without them, I wouldn't be able to upload this video today. The gameplay in the background is going to feature the new cyber attack game mode. It's a twist on the search and rescue mode where you're able to revive teammates. It's kind of like search and destroy, except the bomb plants in 1 second. And in order to pick up the bomb, you need to swap out whatever weapon you have on you at that time. So let's just go ahead and dive right into it. There's a lot that I want to say. Starting off with the overall movement, the speed, the pacing. The game definitely feels different. It doesn't feel like Battlefield. It may look like Battlefield, and some modes, like the 20v20, may really remind you of Battlefield, but it does feel like Call of Duty. You still are able to move fairly quickly. It's just one of those things that takes time to adjust to. It's like using the jetpacks for the first time, except your boots on the ground. That's the best way that I can explain it. If you have never played Advanced Warfare and you popped in that game for the first time and you're just getting used to the jetpack, you're just getting used to the jumps, it's going to take you a couple hours to get used to it. That's what the movement's like in this game, except we're still boots on the ground. There's no jetpacks, and yeah, movement can be fluid. Like I said in a previous video, chaining a super sprint to a slide to a wall brace to a door punch, everything feels amazing in that regard, and I think that they've handled all the new animations quite well. This does impede some things that we've been able to do in the past, like drop-shotting extremely quickly. You can still do it, it's just very, very hard to pull off successfully. The same thing can be said for quickscoping. Quickscoping in this game still exists, however, if you have the sniper on, the one we got to use was the AS-50 bolt action. Even with the attachments that give you the bonus aim down sight speed, maxing out the aim down sight speed, it's still very slow. This is something that people are not going to be happy with. If you like quickscoping, don't use snipers in this game. Use marksman rifles. That's the best advice I can give you, because a lot of marksman rifles can provide a one-shot kill to the chest and above. But gameplay felt fine. Now remember, we're playing on LAN, so the time to kill is going to be a little faster than when there's an internet connection involved. But the time to kill, I still stand by what I said before. It felt similar to Modern Warfare Remastered. If you played Modern Warfare Remastered recently, just imagine that time to kill in this game. There are attachments that you're able to put onto your weapon to increase the damage your bullets can do. There are also the stopping power rounds in the field upgrades that you're able to get to increase your damage on your weapon for a few kills, but overall, this doesn't have a huge play in what's happening all the time, because everyone's going to be using something different. One thing that took me a while to adjust to was the minimap not appearing on the screen. This is definitely a hot topic right now in the community. The minimap itself, coming from the perspective of a hardcore player, mind you, is something that I rarely use once I learn the flow of the map. From time to time, I'll peek up at it, but that's only when I have a UAV active. Otherwise, I'm aware of my surroundings and what's happening right in front of me. I don't know if that's what they were aiming for, but I will tell you, at first, trying to learn the map and looking at the minimap, I use that to see if there's an area that I'm able to jump up on or if there's an area that I need to avoid completely. I found, at first, when exploring these maps for the first time, I was running into doors that I thought I could open, I was jumping onto things that I thought I could climb, and that just wasn't the case. I was jumping into stuff that wasn't playable area, and normally the minimap would give me that information and I would say, okay, I can't run through that door, okay, I can't jump onto this train car, or I can't jump onto this ledge, but you don't have that immediate information, so it's really up to you to learn that unless there's a personal UAV in the air and unless there's a regular UAV in the air. Now, it's been confirmed already by the developers that competitive players will have a minimap on at all times, and I think that that is fine for competitive play, but multiplayer is also competitive in its own right, so I'm kind of torn as a player right now, because I'm thinking like this. Hey, it's kind of cool that they're doing something new, but at the same time, inside, I'm saying, well, if it ain't broke, then why are you trying to fix it? You know what I'm saying? Like, it should always be there, it feels like. I guess maybe this is their idea of removing your spatial awareness in order to have you focus more on the re-engineered sound that they worked very hard on in this game. And I think that the sound is amazing in this game. However, I know that there are people out there that may not have a headset. There are people that use their TV or monitor speakers to play. Yes, you're hearing this correctly. There are still people who play the game this way. And this is going to impede them greatly. It's not going to be easy for them. This is why people don't play hardcore, because they like to have their mini-map. Weapons, they felt pretty good. In certain cases, weapons had a lot of recoil, and I guess that's to be expected, especially when you're dealing with the new features that weapons bring to this game. Caliber and velocity, they all matter, and that will represent directly on your weapon and how it feels in-game. Some weapons feel much heavier, meaning you're going to move a lot slower. So if you have an LMG, you're going to be moving at a snail's pace. But if you have an SMG or an AR, it's going to feel like any other Call of Duty where you're able to run extremely quickly. These are all things that you have to take into account when you're playing the game, and depending on what mode, you may want to switch up your class. One of the coolest things that I think that they've ever done in Call of Duty is this game allows you to actually customize your class in-game. You aren't required to leave to the lobby, create your class, and then go back into a match. You can actually customize it. You can use different attachments. You can use the gunsmith all in-game. That, to me, is awesome. And I'm very, very happy they did something like that. I don't know if this is going to be available in the full game. I'm really hoping that it is. I like being able to do stuff on the fly like that. So I'm really hoping that it stays in the game, just for the sake of my sanity. Speaking of which, the sake of my sanity keeps draining and going down the toilet because there's just so many different conspiracy theories online saying that crossplay doesn't exist, or it's not going to work, or it's just not a thing. I can confirm two different times. Back in May, we had a chance to play crossplay. It was PC, Xbox, and PS4 all in the same lobby, all playing together, and nothing has changed. It's still PC, Xbox, and PS4 all playing together, all in the same lobby. In July, so I don't know why anyone's saying that this doesn't exist when it does clearly exist and it is something that we all just experienced. Even the beta is going to have crossplay functionality, so I don't really know why people keep saying this isn't a thing. At this point, I think maybe people are just trying to troll and get a rise out of other people, but I mean, I'm just sitting here like, hey, I just played it, so I don't really know. But yeah, crossplay is definitely a thing, it's definitely happening, and it's definitely going to be in the beta, so try it out. Map design was a little weird. It's not three-lane designs anymore. There are still three-lane-esque inspirations in the maps themselves, but they're not really three-lane design. They're more open, they're more explorable, there's lots of different things that you can do in a map rather than being funneled towards the enemy. You have lots of different choices when it comes to how you want to play, and the maps reflect that, especially when it comes to what weapons you're using. We just got done talking about how there's just so much customization and changing to your play styles. The maps definitely complement the way that the gunsmith works, and to me, that was just such a refreshing thing to see. We've been stuck on similar maps for so long, but the problem is, we've seen Infinity Ward try to do something like this before. The big example that I can get is Stonehaven from COD Ghosts. This was the complete opposite of a three-lane map, and people liked it in some cases, but also hated it because it was the laggiest, the frame-droppiest, and just overall, the most annoying map to play in that game. I'm not saying that every map is Stonehaven, by the way. I'm just saying that they finally perfected what they were trying to do with Stonehaven, and it's actually very satisfying. Same thing with the streaks. They're super satisfying to use. They're very deadly, and if you're able to get some of the highest streaks in this game, you're gonna do so much damage that you're gonna shit your pants. We're talking Modern Warfare 2 days of damage. You can even put on a perk called Kill Chain to have your kill streaks chained to other kill streaks, just like Modern Warfare 2. So if you wanted to use the Pavlo and then chain that into a chopper gunner and then chain that into a juggernaut, you can do exactly that. It comes down to how you're feeling and, once again, choices and how you want to play. We honestly didn't get to see much of the operators in this game throughout the times that we've played. Operators are the characters that you choose. Each operator has their own unique execution, which you can do by sneaking up behind an enemy and knifing them. The executions are tied to specific operators. However, I feel like this is a good part to bring up one of the biggest concerns that I have about this game so far. Microtransactions. Yes, this game is ripe for microtransactions, and I think that they're going to be the worst that we will ever see in Call of Duty. And that's just because there's so many different things that they could put a microtransaction on. Executions, outfits, characters, weapon customization, and I'm talking about camouflage patterns, attachment variants. They could put little scuffs and scratches and things like that on the weapons, custom stocks, you know, all the different type of things that you come to expect in some sort of supply drop system. Which, by the way, we asked about microtransactions, we asked about anything that we could, and unfortunately, we got hit with a cold shoulder. We weren't getting any information about it, so right now, we don't know it. See, the biggest problem is, when we're playing this game right now, in its purest form, no microtransactions. It is so much fun. I have a good time with it. But I know only a couple of months down the line, or maybe even less than that, maybe a couple of weeks down the line, we're going to start seeing microtransactions and the fangs are going to come out. That's my biggest concern for this game. Everything else that I played, I really enjoyed. I actually did. Whether that's the nostalgia talking because I can use the MP7 and run and gun, or maybe it's because I can put a sniper scope on a shotgun and it's just fun to do crazy shit like that. I'm scared for microtransactions. That's it. Now, at this point, you might be thinking, well, you don't have to buy them. And I agree. I don't. I don't have to buy them. And I've brought it up before, but it's just that point of you see all the stuff that they could have put behind some sort of earning mechanism or a challenge or something like that. But instead, they put it behind some sort of paywall. They put it behind some sort of RNG supply drop system. That's my concern. I want to use cool shit. I want to customize my operator. I want to do these things. But knowing that the DLC is going to be free this year when it comes to maps because the season pass has been thrown into the trash, they're going to have to make up their money somewhere else. And it really does make me concerned. If anyone from Activision is watching this, if anybody from Infinity Ward is watching this, please fight. Please fight for your game. Activision, don't fuck this up. We all had a really good time. We all have good shit to say because the game is fun at its core. Please don't fuck this up. Please. I know in a few months I'm going to come back and revisit this video. And yeah, that's everything I just said probably not going to matter. Oh yeah, one of my biggest nitpicks about this game so far is the realism mode, aka the night vision mode. I'll go ahead and put some gameplay on here at the end so you guys can check it out. I like the idea of using the night vision goggles, but the realism mode, this is coming from a hardcore player, by the way, I need more indications that I'm killing somebody. When you kill somebody in this mode, there's no indication. You don't get a hit marker, you don't get anything like that. It's just you're shooting and they're gone, and that's the end of it. I need indications to tell me that I'm getting a kill. I need those indications. We tried telling you that back in May, Infinity Ward. You need to add some sort of red hit marker or a little pop-up that shows when you kill somebody, because I'm so confused when I'm shooting at somebody and I don't know if I get the kill or not, or if my teammate gets the kill. It's just very, very confusing. The other thing that I don't necessarily like about this mode is there's really no point for it to be a realism mode. Just turn on the HUD and make it a night vision map. That's pretty much all it needs to be. One shot to the head is cool because it reminds me of the old days of Halo, but at the same time, you can get hit by a stray bullet from someone that's not even shooting at you and die. So it's really confusing overall. I like the idea of it. I like the concept of it, but it definitely needs some more work because right now it's just in this weird place. I've played it a few times now and I still don't feel comfortable with it, which is really weird because I love the night vision goggles and how they work in this game. I hope that they have more usage in the standard multiplayer because this night vision mode, it's definitely going to be one of those things where I play it like once and then I never touch it again. At the end of it all, though, I just want to simply say I had a really, really good time with Modern Warfare, minus the microtransactions, in its purest form. I had a great time. I'm excited to play more. I'm excited for the beta. I cannot wait to play it again. There's still, like, little things that I'm, you know, nitpicky about, which we just discussed in this video, but overall, I feel like the game can only get better since there's more time to work on it. And, you know, with this said, I think that this is the best pre-alpha that we've ever had the chance to experience. I think it's the smoothest feeling. It's definitely in a way better place than Infinite Warfare ever was, might I add. And I think that they're way farther along with this development than they ever have been. So I'm excited for the future. I'm also nervous for the future. But right now, I think Modern Warfare is really fun, and I can't wait to play it again. But those are my thoughts and feelings on Modern Warfare. I hope you all enjoyed today's video. If you did, take a moment of your time to click the like button down below. Don't forget to subscribe for more awesome videos coming each and every day. And of course, if you're new to the channel and you have not yet, please do not forget to ring the notification bell next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. I'll catch you all in the next one. Peace!